Hello friends, most of us must be very curious to know about N95 mask, and this is the understanding which I gathered after reading about it. The N95 is a standard which is given by NIOSH, National Institute of Occupational Safety and Health, and although it's a medical grade device, if you look at the authorizing agency, it's more about occupational health. So it was made into looking the occupational exposures and what a user has to use in those circumstances to prevent them from occupational diseases. And this found a lot of application in control of the spread of infectious diseases because of the standards which these masks meet. And we will be talking about what an N95 signifies. Generally, the material which is used is a plastic polymer. Polypropylene is most commonly used, although you can have different kinds of polymers being used for different layers, which gives them different qualities. And they are all threads which are non-woven, that is non-knitted, like cotton we knit together to make a fabric. Here, they are actually held together by other forces. And they are generally in multiple layers, 4 to 5, because these multiple layers improve the filter efficiency, and you can use different kind of fabrics spun in different methods to give you different advantages. The two technology which are mostly talked about is spun bond and melt blown. So these polypropylene threads, which are really, you can call them truly microfilaments, are held together. The spun bond has slightly larger filament size, but the melt blown has really very small fibers. And these are held together either by some physical forces, thermal or airflow, or by some chemical properties, but they are not woven. Probably this is what makes them a little unstable, non-washable. And all of them are meant to be of single use because probably the threads do not remain very stable for very long. If you look at the 95 prefix, it talks about the filtration efficiency of particles which are 0.3 microns or more in size. And they talk about particulate matter. And when they do the test, they use sodium chloride. So there is no mention about organisms here, they just mention about the size. But if you look at the size of organisms, most bacteria and fungus would be larger than this size. So the pore itself can beat it. Viruses may be smaller than this, the coronavirus is. But this is the minimum that they protect you against. 95% of this particulate matter will not enter. But truly speaking, they will give you protection up to 0.1 to 0.2 microns. Which is what the size of the virus is. Pore size is not the only thing which determines the filtration efficiency. It is also about electrostatic charges. Some of them are charged and they can electrically hold back the viral particles. And also when the particle size becomes very small, like 0.3 microns and less, their movement kinetics also change. What are known as Brownian movements. I don't have much scientific knowledge into it, but that makes their entry is difficult through the mask. There are other standards also which these masks have to meet. Permeability. They should not be permeable, so they should be splash proof. If you have body fluids splashing against the mask, maybe blood, then likely it should not permeate inside. Well, they protect you. This permeability also makes them kind of water resistant. So liquids cannot permeate through it very easily. This also tells you that you cannot wash this mask because they repel the water. Fit is another important part, because if the mask doesn't fit your face well and there are leaks, then the particles can enter through them. N95 do not strictly have to go to the fit test, unlike the Chinese counterpart, KN95. But what the fit test tells you is how the mask fits every time you wear it, and for different contours of face. So you have masks also coming in different configurations, and you should find out what is appropriate for your face. And resistance, breathability, how well you are able to breathe through the mask, because that we have to do. The mask has to be such that it allows the air to come inside with minimal effort. It is slightly more difficult to breathe with a mask on, but okay, we think with these standards, probably we would be able to do that. And we are actually doing that. There is no other way. This entire way this mask is made and it works, makes it a single-use product. So if you're using it, maybe after 4 to 8 hours, you got to throw it away. This was what was the recommendation before the COVID outbreak. And this has changed. Probably this has brought back sanity. And this has made us to think how we can reuse these masks. And the principles of reuse are, the mask should be decontaminated. When we are wearing it, we expect the outer surface to become contaminated by viruses, bacteria. They are held back, but they are not killed. They stay on the outer surface of the mask. If we take it off and dispose it, it's fine, because we believe the inner layer is still protected, which is next to our skin. So there has to be a way in which we can kill these viruses and bacteria on the body of the mask and use it again. It should still maintain the filter efficiency. So the fiber, their arrangements, they do not become deranged. You have to do something. And I said these are delicate fibers, arranged in a delicate way. And they have to be intact. They got to be fitting again and again to the contours of your face. The masks become loose with repeated use. There are fabrics now being used in these masks in some layers to make them take the shape better. So technology is evolving, but still, whenever you reuse the mask, this is another consideration that you should have. What are the methods available that we have? One is cycling. Reuse the mask, as the AIIMS protocol said, after 5 days. And why? Because the virus will not survive on that mask for so long. It will become a dead virus, so you are protected. So take longer cycles. And the general rule has been, one mask, use it the 5th or the 6th day, and have a reservoir of 5 to 6 masks with you. Or if you have more at your disposal, okay, just use and throw. The methods are heat. So this is also specified, 60 to 80 degrees humidity, 70 degrees Celsius, how to achieve that, because that is what will protect the fibers and still kill the virus. We got to use easier ways, like keeping it in our car. But wherever you keep the mask, that should be a breathable pouch. So that is why these masks, whenever we are meant to reuse, you should always keep them in a paper bag. Do not seal them in an airtight container, because that destroys the property of the mask. So what we would do probably is leave it in our car, maybe somewhere. Humidity in this country is always around 60 to 80%. We in Assam, we have higher humidities even, and the temperatures might reach that. You can keep it against a reflective surface, whatever, but let the temperature rise at that point so that the organisms are killed. The other is UV light, which is very, very interesting. So many UV chambers being sold. There are specifications, what wavelengths, how long, you should know it. But hospitals and even workplaces are having more and more UV chambers. They can be used to also disinfect other things like mobiles and keys. And the third is use of hydrogen peroxide spray. This is best done in a medical facility, in an organized way. It just cannot be done at home. So if you're looking at home, maybe you use the heat and humidity, that is the best. Hang your mask maybe in open heat. When you store them, keep them in a breathable pouch, and always be aware that the outer surface may still be contaminated, and look at the fit again and again whenever you reuse. And if you really find it doesn't fit you well, it got to be thrown. Also, if you find visible splashes and the mask visibly soiled, it should be changed. Otherwise, maybe not for the availability anymore, because they are generally well available, to decrease the biomedical waste, maybe we can reuse this mask. Make your own choice. if you are really in a zone where your exposures are very high, if you have availability, or probably the best thing would be to use and throw. I wish we had reusable N95 masks, but I don't know if there are any ones which are US FDA approved, which is what we follow most. So this is what we will have at our disposal. Make sure that you use it properly. Make sure you can test the quality of your N95 mask by what I have said. They don't burn. If you splash water on them, they don't permeate, and they are fairly breathable. Select your own brand, because there are so many available, and make sure that you get the right product, because that is what is going to save you. This is a virus which stays in air. Mask is what gives you maximum protection. I wish you all good health. I would like to have inputs on what everyone else has to tell about the N95 mask to learn from all of you.